Welcome, Inventor users. Welcome to another I Get It live session. My name is Timothy Harrison, and I'm a content creator and Autodesk consultant with I Get It. Today, in our session, we're going to look at something new in Autodesk Inventor 2022. This new feature is called Model States. We're going to look at a highlight introduction to this new feature, and Model States are available in both the part and assembly environments. And we're going to look at them real quick in a couple of these different environments. In this session, our objectives will be to introduce what model states are. We'll create new model states in the part environment. We'll also create new model states in the assembly environment. And then we'll also look at how model states affect your iProperties. So there's something interesting there as well. And with that, let's just jump straight into Autodesk Inventor. So here we have a simple flange manifold part that we've created. And let's say that you have parts that you have situations where you have multiple variations of this particular part. And in the past, you may have done a save copy as. Now you have a separate file. Maybe you have multiple files. And they're all kind of a variation on the same type of part. Just a little bit of modification in a length or a series of holes. And maybe you want a situation where you want to be able to just kind of manage all that in one spot. We now have in the browser, you notice up here in the upper left corner, we have an item here for model states. And this folder is added similar to like we've had in the past where we've had design views where you have a master design view. If we open up this folder, we have a master model state. So this is your default. This is kind of how you would normally have had a model in the past. You just had one version of this model. We can now have multiple versions of the model within the same part file. If we right-click on this, we can select New. And now it'll create a new model state. And by default, the first model state that's created is called Model State 1. Just like everything else in the browser, we can select on this and change this to a different name, something that may be more descriptive for what this particular model state is. Some of the other items here in this location, we have these pencil icons. So notice the blue pencil icon on this model state says that we're currently editing this particular model in the model state, and that this model state is active by the check mark that's here. If we double click on the master, notice that we changed and we're now active in the master and we're editing the master. If for you have a reason that you've made multiple model states, but you need to make a change across all of the model states, we'll select this gray pencil icon. And now you notice that there's a blue pencil icon on both model states, indicating that they're both currently edited. So any changes will affect all model states in this situation. We're going to look at this one that we created, and we're going to toggle this off and activate that model state 1. So notice we're active in model state 1, and we're currently editing model state 1. So we have this series of holes here. Say we have a version of this where, in this case, if we edit this, notice that we have a pattern of 6 holes. Say we have a version of this that only has 3 holes. Everything else on this part is the same, but it only needs 3 holes. So we can go here, we'll select 3 and change this pattern. So simple edit. Now we have 3 holes on this particular part file instead of the 6. If we go back to our master model state, notice that we still have 6 holes in our master, but only 3 in our model state 1. We can make additional changes to this. Let's say we're gonna copy this one. So now we have another model state that we've created. And let's change this and we'll just call this model state 2. So this is a copy of the previous one that only had 3 holes. We're gonna edit this one. And let's make a change to the overall length. So let's change this overall length to 100. So notice that the whole part has gotten longer, but our holes are kind of in the wrong spot now because of the sketch that was used to create those. So we'll go ahead in here and we'll make an edit to this sketch as well. And let's change this, let's try 60. So notice the holes have moved up, but we still have an issue where we're missing that spot face that was there. We can go ahead and we can edit this hole. And let's drag the spot face in. That looks about good there. And we'll select OK. All right, so now we have our taller part with our three holes and the spot face in the right orientation and position that we wanted it. Now let's go back to this model state one. Notice that everything updates to the previous settings. So anything that's currently an iProperty, anything that's currently a feature of the existing model can be updated. If you add things or change things, that'll affect what happens with the model. But anything that's currently existing can be modified. So any of these values, any of these numbers that either exist in a sketch or exist in a feature can be updated in this model state. We go back to master. Notice that we're back to that original shorter part with the six holes. As far as iProperties, if we go to the iProperties dialog box, notice in the dialog box now it says flange manifold and then master. So we're looking at the iProperties for the master model state for this. If we go to part number, we currently have a part number of FM 1001. If we close this and we right click, let's go ahead and we'll activate this model state one. Go to iProperties. Notice now that manifold model state one is shown in the dialog box here. And then we can change this part number. Let's say we'll change this to 2. We'll select apply and close. So now currently iProperty for this part number is 1002. If we go back to the master, notice that our part number is FM 1001. So you can have multiple sets of iProperties based upon the typical the type of model state that you're showing for this particular model. This is just a real simple look into this. You can get really, really involved on what you could change in your part file. But the biggest thing to remember is anything that's current, any number that's currently shown in any of the values, whether it's in a sketch, whether it's in a feature, any of those numbers can be modified in your different model states. So let's take a look at assemblies real quick. We're going to close this one. We're just going to cancel this. We're going to hide that one for a minute and expand this. So we have this same part file. We're going to update this to make sure all our changes are shown here in this assembly. So we have an assembly with this part file, and we have a pipe fitting here that we're going to add to this. So in the browser here for the assemblies, notice under our part, we have this folder again for model states. So we can decide which model state we want in our assembly. We can either have the master, or we can select between these other ones. Notice now we have the part file that only had 3 holes, or the part file that has 3 holes and is extended longer. And then these iProperties are also affected within this assembly. So you could insert this same part file multiple times and have different versions of it based upon which model state is active for that particular instance. Let's go ahead and we're going to insert this pipe fitting. And one of the things to keep in mind when you're inserting into models, when you have different model states, and this is something you kind of have to think about ahead of time, is if you're going to insert this and pattern it. So we're going to insert this particular pipe fitting and pattern it around this part, similar to the holes were patterned. One thing to keep in mind is to try to insert your fitting, in this case, to the first hole that was created for the pattern and not to one of the pattern holes, because as we'll see in a minute, you can kind of, it'll kind of do some funny things if you don't insert it to the very first hole. So we're going to look at, we're just going to look at this real quick. Actually, you know what, we're going to save this and we'll close this so we can edit it in context with the assembly. All right, so then we're going to double click this. So now let's look at this pattern hole and see which one is the very first instance. So the first instance or first occurrence of this particular hole is here on the right side of the part. So we'll turn here and then we'll just insert into that particular hole. make sure we're going in the right direction and select OK. All right, so now we have this part inserted on here, and then we're going to pattern this. So we'll do a pattern, we'll select the component, we'll select the feature to pattern to, and then we'll select OK. So now we have our little assembly here with this flange, these pipe fittings that are attached to it, and this is great. But what if we have a different version of this particular assembly with a different model state, and we want to insert different instances of this assembly into another assembly? So we can also do the same thing with model states here as well. The model state folder is available for this assembly environment. Again, we have a master version that's created by default. If we right click on here and select new, again, we now created a new model state 1 for this assembly. This still works the same way as we just looked at in the part environment where we're currently editing this particular model state, or if we want to edit all model states, we select on the toggle icon here. We're going to look at this model state 1. And in this case, we're going to change the model state that is being referenced in this particular assembly for model state 1. So we're going to select model state 1 on the part environment, and notice that when we changed the model state that's referenced in this assembly, it also automatically updated the component pattern. We'll create another model state. So now we're active on model state 2. And now we'll activate model state 2 here. Notice again, we've updated the particular model state that was for the part file, and now we have a model state for that particular pattern as well. So we cycle through these model states. You can see the different versions of assembly model states that are then also referencing different versions of the part file model state. Additionally, in assemblies, we also have an item for substitutions. So in this folder, we'll select new substitute, and then we can either derive the assembly, simplify this assembly, or create a part file. Let's do a simplify. So all the items here are currently selected. If we select an item, we can remove them from this particular simplification. And for this substitution, we're going to remove all holes. So we'll select all. We select highlight, we can get kind of a preview of all the holes that are going to be removed from the for the substitution. And then we'll select OK. And just that fast, we've created a substitute. So now we have a substitute version or a substitute model state that has no holes. So we have four different model states. We have model state for our master, model state 1, model state 2, and a substitute model state. And again, you'll notice that all the holes have been removed from this particular model. All right, everybody. So that's just a quick little look into the new model states feature in Autodesk Inventor 2022. If you'd like more information on this or other topics, visit myigetit.com. One of our newest Inventor courses is Model-Based Definition for Autodesk Inventor. This is a self-paced course with hands-on projects, so I highly recommend checking that one out. And additionally, we have a huge Autodesk library, including the Autodesk Inventor catalog, which has over 40 hands-on projects just for Inventor alone. So please check us out at myigetit.com. And again, my name is Timothy Harrison. If you have any questions about this particular feature, or you have any other suggestions for a future session, please send me an email, tim@myigetit.com. Would be great to hear from you guys. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel. Please subscribe to see new updates for Inventor and all our other CAD training. And I hope to see you next time in another live session.